Cassie, I've got a feeling you're not being yourself.
However could you possibly mean such a thing, pray do tell?
I just don't know what I want since I came out.
You want to be all gay and fabulous? Why aren't you being fabulous? Be fabulous.
You should get on your knees and worship my fanny. What are you doing?
Getting on my knees to worship your fanny.
Are you going to get a nice boyfriend?
I need to walk again.
Hey, Mr. Bartender, give me a drink. I want a cold, wet glass with bubbles in it. And that doesn't mean I can't handle anything stronger now. Just think I'll wait a while.
You're right, my Billy Big Boss.
Yeah, I'm just a bit shagged.
Why?
Because of all our shagging.
We've been eye like rabbits, haven't we?
Yeah.
S&M rabbits.
Yeah.
S&M rabbits who like to stick kitchen utensils up the jacks's.
Yeah. Potato masher might have been a bit much, though. And we fart smell like King Edward's.
I'm ready for round two. Get your trousers off and a stonker on.
Oh, Cassie, please, I can't manage any more sex. Feels like you've been at me cock with me tenderizer.
That's because I have.
I'm exhausted. I don't want this interfering with me footy. I've got to focus on me tackling, not me tackle. My heading skills, not getting head. Am I dribbling, not your dribbling?
You know all the other players' girlfriends? Well, they're all really glamorous, aren't they? Well, doesn't it bother you that I'm not like that? Those wags smell like Paco Rabanne. And I've never wore the same pair of jeans twice. I haven't washed these since 2008, and even then I found them on the pavement outside Scope.
But you've got your own style. A charity shop robbing style. Anyway, I better get to training.
Hey, don't you want to eat your eggs? Keep your strength up.
Cassie, did you make these eggs with the whiskey shoved up my ass?
Maybe.
I might just have some toast.
Well, today's the day, Donna. I, Gaz Wilkinson, I'm going to walk again. I can feel it in my bones. Not the ones in my legs, of course, but my other bones.
Right, I just think you need to do more to walk again than say, I'm going to walk again and then watch endless repeats of Murder, She Wrote.
It's that Jessica Fletcher, I can't get enough of her. Should be called Fanny, She Wrote. Or Murder, She...
Fanny.
Or just Fanny, Fanny, Fanny.
You need to be more proactive to walk, Gaz. The physio said everything's fine. It might even be psychological. You just need to find the motivation. Is there something that can make you get out of that chair? I can't believe I'm doing this. It's like something out of a filthy generation game. You know, it's probably something Jim Davidson actually suggested.
If anything's going to get me out of this chair, it's ultra-hardcore porn. Right, here we go. It's not working!
Go on, Gaz, go on. Go on, turn that page and see what that guy's doing to those blonde twins, eh? Only you can make it happen.
Yes, yes, I can make it happen. Yeah. Oh, shit, it's full! Oh, shit!
Oh. You were so close, Gaz.
I think I'd be more motivated if you just did what the twins were doing yourself.
I can't get my legs that high, and we don't have a butter churn or a curious goat. I could really do with a break from all this.
Why don't you just go and see your mates?
See my mates. Ha! Sorry, that was a bit dramatic, wasn't it? It's just I don't really have any mates. You miss having a girl to talk to. No, about girly stuff that might be happening right now.
Oh, and you can't talk to me about girly things.
Tampons.
Whoa, what are you doing? You know, I have nightmares about them things.
Well, I'm going to go out and get myself a new friend.
Donna, friends aren't like toilet paper, you know. You can't just pop out and get some more when you run out. No, not that you do that with bog roll. I had to use a copy of Heat the other day. It's weird wiping my ass on Paris Hilton's face.
But you're not the first. I just know there's somebody out there who'd be my pal. Somebody who'd understand the real me. Somebody who'd listen to all my womanly woes and worries and tell me it'll be all right. Did you get any of that?
Yeah, of course.
What did I say?
Something about tampons.
Morning, campers. What a beautiful day. Oh, Gaz, I heard how well you were doing in physio. Are you using that pint as a motivation to walk?
No, well, Cassie won't hand it to me.
I love seeing people struggle. That's why I've glued Arthur to the table.
You seem in a good mood, Tim.
I found an exciting new way to locate potential suitors in the area.
You've put your phone number on the toilet wall again?
No, I've never done that.
Oh, no, I did that. I might give you an hand. Or an hand job. Woo!
I meant I popped down to the car phone warehouse and bought myself what's known as a smartphone.
Whoa, Einstein. There's a warehouse for car phones.
Apparently, this smartphone can download apps, which is short for applications.
You're a dickhead, which is short for man with a dick on his head.
Anyway, there's an app here which will help me locate local gay men. This is my chance to form a real spiritual connection with a kindred spirit.
Oh, what's it called?
Shagger.
Sounds filthy. Is he a straight version of it?
I'm sure it's not as dubious as it sounds. I've already met a friendly sort. He sent me a message. It said, hey. Oh, he sent me a photo. Oh, my God.
Oh, he looks very friendly and engorged.
Oh, that's disgusting. I can't even look at it. That's disgusting. It's disgusting. Oh. How do you save photos on this thing?
So where's Billy the Stud then?
He's gone to football training. Look, guys, you and Billy are mates. I'm just a bit worried. He seemed to act differently with me earlier. I don't know if I've done something wrong or if it's...
Oh! Just give me an idea. Maybe football can get me walking again. I'm sure your problem will sort itself out, love.
Did you even hear what it was?
Yeah, of course. Something about tampons. Actually, I've come because, well, football's the thing I miss most, and I thought if I watched you playing my beloved game, I'd want to get out of this pissing chair.
You feel free to go on, Billy, lad. Get in there, son.
Go on, Billy, get in there, son.
Anyway, I better.
Billy, you're really good at football, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Why are you playing like complete shite?
Okay, look. You know I've been seeing Cassie.
Oh, she is really into me. Well, she's kind of got a big appetite.
Oh, I get it. Eating all your food, depriving of your vital nourishment.
No, she's got an appetite for sex. She wants to do it all the time.
You just won the lottery, my friend.
No, you don't understand. I'm always like this. As long as I'm scoring off the pitch, I can never score on it.
Yeah, I was like that when I was a mechanic, you know.
You were crap at fixing cars after you'd had sex.
No, during. Yeah, man, trying to change a fan belt was a right bastard.
It's time I took a stand. Now, if it's affecting me footy, there's only one thing for it.
Yeah, I've got to call it off with Cassie.
Yeah, well, I admire your dedication, Billy, but you're turning down regular sex, you thick twat. That's it! Oh, man, come on, that pass! Quicker! What was that?
Go on, babe. Try and kick it back.
Okay. All right. I can do this.
Go on, babe!
All right, guys, this is it. This is a moment. Come on, Becca, meet your ass out. Let's go. Here we go. Go. Bollocks!
What can I get you, Donna?
Friends, That's all I need, just friends.
Well, you could buy a drink too. I'm trying to run a business here, not a drop-in centre.
Right, seriously, Tim. Since Janet and Louise left, I've got no one. We used to be a three. Now I'm a one. You're like that singer at the Sugar Babes. When the original one left and then swapped with that other girl and then the moody one left for a bit so that the Scouse one could come back, I can't keep up with them.
I'm sure you don't need to look too hard for a best friend. I think you've already found that person. Someone who works behind a bar. A lovable custodian with a devil-may-care smile. Who's speaking to you at this very moment? Me, you gormless spin me!
Oh, that's really sweet, Tim, but I need a female friend. I've got womanly matters to discuss.
Well, I don't mind talking about that stuff.
Okay, well, usually when I have my period...
Oh! Ooh! Oh, now I feel nauseous.
Right, I definitely need a girly pal. Hey, I could talk to Cassie. She technically qualifies as a woman.
Well, yes, in the same way that Victoria Beckham qualifies as a singer.
So, anyway, how's it going looking for a male lover on your... What is it again?
App. It's short for application.
Chuffy now.
And I've given up on that thing. It's nothing but a disgusting den of perverts flashing their private parts. I've literally been on there for hours, being disgusted. I'm never going to find a nice man in Runcorn. They're all animals.
I don't say that. But when the right guy turns up, you'll know.
Hiya, can I get a gin and tonic?
Looks like the right guy might have just turned up.
I see what you mean. Excuse me one moment. Hello there.
You alright, Gaz? Hey, you got mud on your face?
Yes, I know, I fell on it. It might not be mud.
Hey, go on, Billy! Kick some ass!
Intimidating, aren't they? Fit and shaggable, but intimidating.
Do you actually think they're sexy?
Yeah.
And you like the way they dress?
Yeah.
They look like cheap whores.
Yeah.
He's gorgeous. He's like an angel. Go and talk to him.
I don't even know that he's gay.
I'll find out. Using subtle detective work. You gay?
Yes.
Good for you. Keep chasing that rainbow. Action stations, Timothy. He's a paid-up member of the Brotherhood. Go on.
I can't! What if he's another dirty perv like those shagger men?
Well, then it's your lucky day. You've got to seize the moment, carpe penis. He's coming. Talk to him. You'll be fine. Go on.
Hey.
Hey. Oh, I know how this goes. It starts with a hey, and then you're flashing your wing-wang at me.
Excuse me?
What's wrong with you, pervert? What are you into? Fisting? Rimming? Shrimping?
Sorry, have I said something wrong?
Ah, you're all the same. Only interested in the contents of my underpants. Well, there's nothing in there. Well, I mean, nothing for you. Do you think I'm some sort of sex obsessive?
It kind of sounds like you are.
Yeah, well, you wish. I'm sorry to disappoint you, but you're not getting what you want from me.
I just want a drink. And to say hey.
Oh! Oh, right. Oh! Hey.
I think it's going very well.
God, I played like crap. I might as well be in the England squad. Look, I don't think you should come watch me play anymore, Cassie.
I know what this is about. You're ashamed of me.
No! Look, I don't want to have to do this, but... Maybe we should take a break for a while.
Take a break? We've been shagging less than a week.
We've done it like 1,000 times.
34 and a half, actually. We got kicked out of the church halfway through.
No, we probably should have waited till after that funeral. I'm sorry, Cassie, but I've got to focus on my football.
Go on then. You leave. You walk out that door. Let's just see if you do it.
Okay, bye.
He did it.
Hi, Cassie. Mate.
What do you want?
Well, I just thought that we could have a friendly chat. Like comrades, sisters, amigos, if you will.
I won't.
But seriously, Cassie, if something's bothering you, you can talk to me.
It's just Billy. There's all these glammed-up tarts go to watch him play football, and I know he prefers girls like that to me.
Well, then you know what you've got to do. You've got to fight fire with fire.
Yeah? I'll get some petrol and torch the stupid bitches.
No, Cassie. Fire bad.
You've just got to beat them at their own game. You've got to see their fake tans and raise them a push-up bra.
Yeah, I guess I could do that.
Yeah. So now that we've sorted out your problems like good girlfriends, I was wondering if we could have a chat about some feminine issues that have been affecting me lately.
I guess.
Okay, well, usually when I menstruate...
Oh, what is your problem?
You're a woman.
In the same way that Victoria Beckham...
Yeah, Tim's already done that one.
I'm sorry for going a bit mad at you earlier. I've just had some bad experiences with men lately.
I understand. There are a lot of salacious guys about.
Ooh, you just said salacious. Are you sure you're from round here?
Well, I'm from Frodsham.
Frodsham? The Monte Carlo of the Northwest? Is it as magical as people say?
It's 10 minutes down the A56.
The A56. You know, I'd really like to get to know you.
Leonard. Yeah, school was a lot of fun for me.
Well, you seem nice, Leonard. And so far, I seem crazy. Will you give me the chance to prove I'm not a batshit wacko?
That sounds good. Oh, but I need to pop out and do something.
Oh, I get it. Is this because I accused you of being a pervert and said you wanted to look at my wing-wang?
No, that stuff's marvellous. I've just left my phone in my car. I'll come back. Trust me.
I do. Of course I do.
What's up, Tim?
I've been dumped. He's never coming back. I've ruined my first chance at real happiness since Helena.
You've got it easy. I was this close to kicking a ball again with everyone watching. Fell in a pile of mud. Smells like dog shit. I really want to walk again. I know I can. I just don't know what's wrong with me.
Well, if your physio thinks your problems are psychological, maybe it's the sterner approach you need. Our old friend, Mr. Tough Love. I could get you angry, give you a load of abuse, and motivate you to get out of the chair.
Well, I'm game. How do we start?
You're a pathetic little bastard.
Hey, piss off, arsehole. Oh, sorry. That was that part of the Tough Love?
Yes, sir. Look at you. You're hopeless. I can river dance and you can't. Because I'm not a loser in a wheelchair.
This is pretty good, because I want to get out of the chair and batter you. Come on, let's crank it up a notch.
Okay. Come on, drag your lazy fat ass out of that chair, you useless invalid. Why can't you walk like the rest of us? Stupid.
Oh. What are you doing?
Leonard, I wasn't expecting you to come back.
I think the clues were there when I said, I'll come back. I didn't realise I'd find you doing this.
Oh, no, you don't understand. This is my friend. I was just helping him. This always works. Well, it usually works.
I'll see you, Tim.
Oh, no, Leonard, wait!
Oh. Well, don't worry about it, Tim. He'll be back.
Will he?
I piss him well, doubt it.
I know you wanted us to have a break for a while, and I know you didn't want me coming here, but I thought if I dressed up a little
bit... What are you wearing?
Well, you don't think it's sexy?
Well, I didn't say that.
Good. So I'm wearing three things I've never worn before. Heels, perfume and knickers. Go right up my chuff.
But why? You like wearing 10-year-old ripped jeans and T-shirts with suck me cock on it?
Well, yeah, but you want me to be sexy like that, what? Well, that's why you've been avoiding me, because I'm not some umpa-lumpa with bazumpas like them.
I love the way you are, Cassie.
Really? I thought you wanted me to be glamorous. thought you didn't fancy me.
No, I fancy you too much. That's the problem, love.
Anyway, they aren't glamorous. Rita works down the sewers. Shannon used to be a trained butcher. And Tracy used to be called Trev.
I'm telling you, Cassie, you're the best looking girl here, hands down.
Really? Well, in that case, Billy McCormack, how would you like some company tonight?
No way, I've just said if I spend the night with you, I'm going to be crapping tomorrow's football game. Not happening, football's my life.
Oh, well, that's a shame. So I'm thinking of tying you down, sitting on your face, and spanking your ball bag with a spatula.
Football's only a game. Let's go.
Hey, hang on, aren't you in the middle of practicing now?
Oh, yeah, got caught up in the moment and all.
That's my man!
John!
Well, thanks for meeting me, Hazel. I hope you didn't think it was weird. Me putting up ads around town saying I wanted to meet people.
I completely understand. I'm very open-minded.
Is that a leather belt you're wearing?
Oh, yeah. It's nice, isn't it?
Tell me, why do you think it's acceptable to wear a slaughtered animal around your waist?
It was £3 in Primark. Anyway, Hazel, now that we're pals, there's something that I'd really like to talk to someone about.
Tell me, Donna, are you passionate about the environment?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Isn't it terrible how all them carbon fumes are making that oil leak everywhere? Melting those ice caps and killing all them poor polar bears. And soon, all we'll be left with is an oily polar bear on a defrosted carbon footprinted ice cap. Did any of that make sense?
You clearly don't know what you're talking about, Donna. And the fact that you're wearing a leather belt says a lot about you.
Look, Stigger the Dump. It doesn't make me a bad person just because I'm wearing something that stops my trousers falling down.
I don't think we can be friends, Donna.
Oh, yeah. Oh, well, what a crushing blow. Why don't you go shag a tree, Bono?
It's really nice having a new friend, especially after my boyfriend dumped me last week. Not that I'd use you as a replacement for John.
Of course not.
Could you cut your hair short and let me call you Joan?
What are you wearing?
Hey, do you like Justin Bieber?
So, after I cut him up into small pieces, I put him in the deep freeze and then I buried him in the woods. How people consider that murder, I've got no idea.
Next!
You know what? I am having a really nice time, Anna.
Me too. I think you're really cool, Donna.
You're not a mass murderer? Or a vampire or a Justin Bieber fan?
Of course not, silly.
Well, thank God for that.
It's just so hard to meet other gay women round here.
I never stood a chance with Leonard. He's way out of my league. He's from Frodsham, for God's sake.
Frodsham? Was he a millionaire?
Anyway, what about me? I've still not found a girly best mate.
You've still not found one yet?
What, you still haven't walked yet?
Well, that's sensitive. I wonder why you haven't got any friends.
Because they're all eco-freaks, vampires and predatory lesbians.
Predatory lesbians?
Shut up, Gaz.
Why don't you just give up?
I could find a friend if I wanted. Yeah, I could befriend someone as soon as look at them. Even her. Come to mama, bosom buddy. Well, hello there, partner. You look like a nice sort who'd enjoy a girly chat. That's right. So, have you got a name?
Kerry. People call me Kez.
Well, that is brilliant. Like the Kestrel. You know, the Kestrel. Call Kez. Come to, Kez, come to. Come to.
You're pissing me off now.
What?
No!
Thank you.
Christ, you walked. You're walking.
Not right now, Donna. I'm on my ass.
You got up and walked. You walked across the pub. You're on your feet.
No, Donna, I'm still on my ass.
Stop ruining the moment.
Sorry.
Well, can you do it again, Gaz? Come to, Gaz. Come to. Come on, Gaz, try. Dear, think about how you'll be able to shag me up against the wall again.
And I'm up. Well, I guess I found my motivation. It was just my instinct to protect you, baby. Right?
I am finished with you.
Oh, yes, you have, sugar tits. You don't come in my pub and threaten my customers. Now, sling it.
You're going to make me Russell Grant.
You're the one that's going to be seeing stars in a second, bitch. Now, get out, you dirty biffer, and don't come back. And if you ever threaten my friends again, I'll open a can of whoop-ass on you and a big fat carton of bitch slap.
Leonard, I didn't think you'd come back.
Oh, what can I say? Your drinks are reasonably priced.
I know you just saw me manhandling that girl and threatening to bitch slap her. Oh, you must think
I think you're pretty heroic, Tim, sticking up for your friends like that. And you're surprisingly forceful when you're angry. How about you stop talking whilst I still think you're heroic? You tend to say the wrong thing when you speak.
Yeah,
What did I just say?
That little piggy there went to market. This little piggy went to town. And this little piggy tickles when I do it. Oh, it's me, look.
It's amazing, Gaz walking again. It is a miracle. It's a modern day miracle.
Like Fern Cotton's career.
Yeah.
So, I guess you discovered something tonight when you failed to make any new friends.
What, that I'm a crap friend?
You're not crap. You helped Gaz to walk again. You helped me with Leonard. You helped Cassie with Billy.
You're right. I am freaking awesome. So what did I learn then?
That you don't need anyone new because you've got us. And you can always talk to me about anything. Even stuff about your down belows.
Really?
Of course. So what's been bothering you so much lately?
I missed my period. I think I might be pregnant.
The guy at the bar's my ex. He's a complete psychopath.
Such a waste of space. I've done nothing worthwhile.
I know something major will happen soon.
Ditch him, or I will kill him.
You can only be with one of us. It's either him or me.
Oh, Donna, it's the hospital.
Hello?
Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm sure they have to do some more tests.
I'd like to go out with you, Tim.
Gaz?
You can see all of that in brand new Two Pints next Tuesday at 10:30. And you can press your red button now to catch highlights of Tiny Temper from this year's Radio 1's Big Weekend.